Hi, hello friends, welcome back to my channel Vijaya Biology Tutorials. Today we are going to learn the worksheet of lesson number 2 of class 9th, that is plant tissues. And before going to the video, please do subscribe to my channel Vijaya Biology Tutorials. Yeah, let's go to the worksheet. Here in this worksheet, around 11 questions are given. In that 11 questions, 4 questions are given in the form of bits, and the remaining questions are given like short answers, and the last 2, 10th and 11th, are given as the essay question and answers. Now let us discuss each bit. And before going to the worksheet, I wanted to tell that here already I have done a video regarding the plant tissues, and if you want, clearly you can go and watch the video and you will get a clear information regarding this lesson. Yeah, now going to the first question. Put tick mark against which cells are helpful to more plant body. Here we know that the plant tissue is having 4 different types of the tissue. The first one is the meristematic tissue, the second one is the dermal tissue, the third one is the ground tissue, and the fourth one is the vascular tissue. So here what they are asking is which one is more important to the plant body. Here dermal tissue is more important to the plant body. Why dermal tissue is most important to the plant body means without the dermal tissue, the internal tissues cannot be protected. If the dermal tissue is damaged, then obviously the internal tissues also gets damaged. Why? Because there is no protection without the dermal tissue. That's why the answer is dermal tissue. Now going to the second question. Put into mark against which cells are not related to the ground tissue. We know that ground tissue is one of the most important plant tissues. In the ground tissue, again we are having 3 types of the tissue. The first one is the parenchymatous tissue, the second one is the colenchymatous tissue, and the third one is the sclerenchymatous tissue. Here what is the question they have asked is we have to put the into mark against which cells are not related to the ground tissue. The answer is epidermis. What is the answer? Epidermis. Next, going to the third question. Here small mistake is there. Actually the question should be colenchyma consist of. So we have to strike out this one. And here what you have to write down is colenchyma. Colenchyma consist of cellulose, hemicellulose, and pectin. Okay, the composition of the colenchyma means the cells which are present in the colenchyma are made up of, their cell walls are made up of 3 important components. Those are cellulose, hemicellulose, and pectin. So here chlorenchyma is given. We have to strike out of that question and we have to write it as colenchyma. Even if they ask chlorenchyma consist of means, we have to write down the chlorenchyma consist of the chlorophyll pigment. The answer is chlorophyll pigment. So if the question is asked as what does the colenchyma consist of means, we have to write down cellulose, hemicellulose, and pectin. And if they ask like what does chlorenchyma consist of, chlorenchyma is one of the parenchymatous tissue and it consists of the chlorophyll. It consists of chlorophyll. That is the answer. Next, moving on to the next one, fourth bit is the parenchyma which contains large air cavities is. The answer is aeranchyma. What is the answer? Aeranchyma. Here we want to know in detail about the parenchymatous tissue means the parenchyma is again having 3 different types of the tissues. The first one is the chlorenchyma, the second one is the aeranchyma, and the third one is the storage tissue. Regarding that one, here aeranchyma is the parenchymatous tissue which is having large air cavities, means there will be having more air cavities in that tissue. And this aeranchyma is generally observed in the plants that live in the water. Like lotus, if you take, the leaves will be floating on the water. So that floating nature to that leaves was got by aeranchyma. It helps the plant to get the buoyancy nature. Buoyancy means nothing but floating nature. As the air cavities do not have any sort of weight, they will be making the leaves to float on the water. So which tissue is present there means aeranchyma is present. Aeranchyma helps in the buoyancy of the leaves or buoyancy of the plants in water. Okay, so the answer is aeranchyma. Next, going to the fifth question. Write the properties of the ground tissue. Already I said that the plant is having four different types of the tissue and one of the tissue is ground tissue. Let us see the properties. If you want, you can write it down, this notes also. Here, ground tissue has cells that appear larger with prominent walls. We know that plant means compulsory, it will be having the cell wall. So the walls will be prominent, means we can clearly demarcate that, we can clearly mark the cell walls. So prominent walls will be present. Next, going to the second point, the tissue forms the bulk of the plant. Bulk of the plant means it forms the completely the plant body, central part of the plant body will be filled with this ground tissue. It will be filled with the ground tissue. Next, it is helpful in storing food and providing physical support to the body. As we already know that parenchyma is having three different types of the tissue. In that different types of the tissue, storage tissue is one of the important tissue, and that storage tissue is helpful in storing the food material. And like sclerenchyma tissue, if you take, it will give mechanical support. Okay, and like colenchyma, if you take, it will give flexibility to the plant. Means here, the ground tissue is helpful in storing the food material as well as giving physical support to the plant. Okay, these are the three points of the properties regarding to the ground tissue. If you want, you can note it down. Next, going to the next question. Write the types of the ground tissue. So here there are three types of the ground tissue. They are parenchyma, colenchyma and sclerenchyma. These are three different types of the ground tissue. Okay, next, going to the seventh question. Write the differences between chlorenchyma and storage tissue. Write the differences between chlorenchyma and storage tissue. If you just hold on, I'll show you the answer. Yeah, here you can see the answer. The chlorenchyma, the parenchyma cells which contains chloroplast is called as chlorenchyma. Already in the previous bit, I have explained you that if the parenchyma cells are filled with the chloroplast, such type of cells are called as chlorenchyma cells. And the second one is storage tissue. The parenchyma cells which stores the water or food material or even the waste products is called as the storage tissue. The name itself is saying that storage means they store something, either it may be an important thing or it may be the waste materials, but its function is to store the materials. That's why it's called as storage tissue. This chlorenchyma and storage tissue together, they come under the parenchyma, which is one of the ground tissue, which is one of the ground tissue. So the answer for that question is this one. Next, going to the next one. What the Nemeth Grew observed in his experiment. This scientist, Nemeth Grew, is the scientist who has named the parenchyma tissue, who has given the name to the parenchyma tissue. So here what they are asking is, through his experiments, what did he observe? What did he observe through his experiments? That is the question. The answer for this question is, Nemeth Grew observed that every plant organ consists of two types of organical parts. One is the pithy part, the other one is the ligneous part. Grew called the pithy part as the parenchyma. So what did he observe means, while he was observing the parts of the plant, he observed two important parts. One is the pithy part. Pithy part in the sense, which is the soft and smooth tissue, nothing but the ground tissue, nothing but the ground tissue. Here the plant is having two important parts. The first one is the central part, which is soft and smooth, that is the ground tissue, and the outside part, that is the ligneous part, generally observed in the barks of the stems. Bark of the stem, you can observe this ligneous part, means external part, nothing but like dermis, you can say. So he observed the pithy part, which is in the center of the plant, and he observed the external part, that is the dermal tissue, which is outside of the plant, means external layer of the plant, and he called that pithy part as parenchyma. That's what we are calling it as ground tissue. So he observed the parenchyma ground tissue as well as he observed the dermal tissue in his experiments. So the answer is this one. Next, going to the next question, moving on to the next question. Write the properties of the sclerenchyma. So sclerenchyma is one of the ground tissue as previously said. So now we are going to write down the properties. Now if you read out the answer, sclerenchyma consists of the long narrow cells with thick and lignified cell walls. In the previous bit, what we have learnt is colenchyma consists of the cellulose, hemicellulose and pectin in their cell walls. But here, the sclerenchyma consists of the lignin in their cell walls. The sclerenchyma consists of lignin in their cell walls. And how are the cells? The cells are long and narrow, where the cell walls are very thick, where you can observe the deposition of the lignin with no intercellular spaces. So there will be no intercellular spaces and the cells will be very compactly arranged, means there will be no gap between the cells and they will be very close to each other. That is the first point meaning. And going to the second point meaning, cells are usually dead without the protoplast. We know that in the first lesson we have said that how we can call a particular cell as a living cell means, if the cell is having protoplasm, then it is called as a living cell. If the cell is not having the protoplasm, it is called as dead cell. Here, the sclerenchymatous cells do not have the protoplasm. That's why they are called as dead cells. Next, what is the function of the sclerenchyma? Sclerenchyma provides mechanical support to the organs. How does it provides mechanical support means, if for example if you take any of the animal which comes for the grazing, if it want to eat any of the fruit or vegetable, if the fruit's outer layer is very tough and hard, it will not eat. Why? Because it can't break it. Okay, in that way it is giving support to the plant. That's what we are saying. The sclerenchyma provides the mechanical support to the organs. So these are the three properties of the sclerenchyma. The sclerenchyma is having lignin in their cell walls and the cells are not having any sort of the intercellular spaces between them, and the cells are usually dead because they are not having protoplasm. What is the function of the sclerenchyma? It provides mechanical support to the organs. So these are the three properties. Next, moving on to the next question. Write the properties of parenchyma and its type. We know already the types of the parenchyma. So now let us read the properties. Parenchyma is a simple tissue and forms the major components within the organs. The cells of the parenchyma are generally isodiametric. They may be spherical, round, oval, polygonal or elongated in shape. So it is a very simple tissue. Parenchyma is very simple tissue where you can observe in mostly the plant parts are made up of parenchymatous tissue. And the cells are having same diameter. So the cells are having same diameter. They may be oval in shape, they may be spherical in shape, they may be round in shape, or they may be elongated also. Means elongated in the sense they may be long also. So these are the first two properties of the parenchyma. Nothing but the parenchyma is a simple tissue where you can observe in major parts of the plant body. They are generally isodiametric. They may be spherical, oval, round, polygonal or elongated. So before going to the next point, just hold on. Yeah, next going to the third point. Their walls are thin and made up of cellulose. So the walls are made up of cellulose. If you observe, now you can make a small comparison between the cell walls of parenchyma, colenchyma and sclerenchyma. Here parenchyma you can observe only, cellulose you can observe, and the walls are thin. The parenchyma cell walls are thin and the deposition of cellulose can be observed. If you come to the colenchyma, the cell walls are thick and they are having deposition of what? They are having deposition of cellulose, hemicellulose and pectin. And coming to the third type of the tissue, that is sclerenchyma, their cell walls are very thick and they are having deposition of lignin. So here parenchyma, if you observe, their walls are thin and made up of cellulose. Next, going to the next point, they may be either closely packed or have small intercellular spaces. So comparing to the colenchyma and sclerenchyma, here the cells are little bit having some intercellular spaces and they are not as much as compactly packed as in the sclerenchyma or colenchyma. Next, what are the functions? Let us see. The parenchyma performs various functions like photosynthesis, storage and secretion. So here we know that photosynthesis, why Why? Because the parenchyma is having chlorophyll. So the parenchyma which contains chlorophyll is called as chlorenchyma. So that is the next point actually. There are three types of the parenchyma. The first one is the parenchyma which contains the chloroplast is called chlorenchyma. The second one is the aerenchyma. Parenchyma which contains large air cavities or spaces is called as aerenchyma. Chlorenchyma is very much important for the process of the photosynthesis. Aerenchyma is very much important in the floating plants. Why? Because it gives the buoyancy nature to the plants, that is floating nature. And the third one is storage tissue. Already said that the storage tissue is helpful for storing the food materials, or it will store the waste materials also. So these are the points regarding to this question. Next, going to the next question. Draw the diagram of sclerenchyma and explain how sclerenchyma is different from the cholenchyma. Diagram I'll show you at the end of the video, and let us discuss the differences between the cholenchyma and sclerenchyma. Cholenchyma and sclerenchyma both come under the ground tissue only. But what are the major differences between them? Let us see. So coming to the first point, cholenchyma consists of cells which are much thickened at the corners due to the deposition of the cellulose, hemicellulose and pectin. Already we know that the cholenchyma is having thick cell walls. And here you can see the deposition of cellulose, hemicellulose and pectin. Now coming to the sclerenchyma. Sclerenchyma consists of the long narrow cells with thick and lignified cell walls. So the cell walls are made up of lignin, and the cell walls are very thick in nature. So here cholenchyma consists of the cellulose, hemicellulose and pectin, while sclerenchyma consists of the lignin. Okay, that is the first difference. Next, going to the second difference. Some cholenchymatous cells contains chloroplast. So we know that only parenchyma consists of the chloroplast and it is called as chlorenchyma. But even in cholenchyma also, some of the cells consist of the chloroplast. Now coming to the second point of the sclerenchyma. Cells are dead and don't have the chloroplast. They are completely dead cells and the protoplasm is completely absent. So as the protoplasm is completely absent, there will be no cell organelles. As there is no protoplasm, it is called as a dead tissue, and as there is no protoplasm, it won't have even chloroplast also. So that is the second difference between the cholenchyma and sclerenchyma. Going to the third difference. It provides cholenchyma. Third point, it provides mechanical support, flexibility to the plant parts. Here, wherever the cholenchyma is present, there the plant will not break, but it will bend. That flexibility will be given by which tissue? Means cholenchyma. Okay, it gives mechanical support. Means if you observe, if heavy wind comes, generally the stems will be waving. They will be waving, but they do not, they will be bending also, but they do not break. What is that nature which is protecting the plant part? Means here in that stems, the cholenchyma will be present, which will be giving flexibility to move along with the wind. Okay, that is the nature which is given by the cholenchyma. Going to the next difference of the sclerenchyma, third difference, it provides mechanical support to the organs. As previously I said that, as the sclerenchyma is a dead tissue which is absorbed in the external layers, it will be giving protection to the internal organs. It will be giving protection to the internal organs. Not only that, it gives mechanical support to the organs. Next, going to the fourth point, where you can observe this cholenchyma. It is present in the young stems, petiole of the leaf. The stalk of the leaf is called as petiole, and here you can observe the cholenchyma in the young stems as well as petiole of the leaf. That's why the reason why the leaves do not break, but they will be just waving along with the wind, means the flexibility nature will be given by the cholenchymatous tissue. Now if you come to the fourth point of the sclerenchyma, it is present in the fruit walls of the nuts, seed coats and of legumes. So fruit walls, if you see pista, if you observe, Okay, walnuts, if you observe, there the wall of the fruit will be very hard in the nature. So that hard nature will be given by the sclerenchymatous tissue. Okay, and even in the seed coats of legumes, generally legumes, what are leguminous plants? Means dal family comes under the leguminous plants, like groundnuts, if you observe, they come under the leguminous plants. Pulses comes under the leguminous plants. So the seed coat which is covered will be present with, which it will be made up of sclerenchyma. So these are the four differences between the colenchyma and sclerenchyma. Here I said that I'll show you the diagrams. Once, if you hold on, I'll show you the diagrams. Here you can see three types of the ground tissue. This one is the parenchyma, second one is the colenchyma, and third one is the sclerenchyma. If you see in the parenchyma, some intercellular spaces are present. The cells are not that much compactly arranged, and the cell walls are also thin in nature, which are made up of cellulose. But if you see colenchyma, the cells are little bit compactly arranged, and the walls of the, means the corners of the cells, are made up of cellulose, hemicellulose and pectin. And third diagram, if you see sclerenchyma is having thick cell walls. You can see double layered cell walls, you can observe in the diagram, and they are made up of, what they are made up of, means they are made up of lignin. So these are the three different types of the ground tissues, and if you want, you can draw the diagram. So next I'll show you different types of parenchymatous tissue. So these are the three different types of the parenchymatous tissue. The first one is the chlorenchyma. Means if the parenchyma consists of the chlorophyll, you can see green color pigment in the diagram. So that's why it is called as chlorenchyma, which helps in the photosynthesis process. The second one is the aerenchyma. You can see large, big sized spaces you can observe here. You can observe the big sized spaces here. Large air cavities are present. These air cavities are present in order to give the plant buoyancy nature. That's why these air cavities are helpful, and as they contain the air cavities, this tissue is called as aerenchyma. And the third one is the storage tissue. In the storage tissue, generally you can see it is helpful for the storage of the food materials, or even the waste materials will be stored by this storage tissue. These are the three different types of the parenchymatous tissue. Okay, so I think you have understood the video. If you have any doubts, you can comment me and I'll answer to your questions. Thank you. If you like the video, please do subscribe to my channel. Thank you.